Hello friends, welcome to my channel, My Mother Book Studio. In today's video, I am reviewing a book set in Ladakh region of India. This book wonderfully highlights the strength and ability of a young blind child and also brings forth the community togetherness, which has always been a norm back in India, with food being the integral part. You would know more when I will take you through the book what exactly I am referring to, and especially if you belong to my era, you would really relate so well to this book because it talks so wonderfully about neighbors, neighborhood, the kind of relationship we all shared with our neighbors while growing up. However, before I proceed with the video, I would want you all to take pause and remind you, in case you haven't subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel. This keeps me really motivated and helps me understand that I'm creating the right kind of content which you all are looking forward to see, listen, and really take it forward to the other people. And in case you would like to know more about reading, the libraries we visit, the kind of activities we do at home, then you can also follow me on my Instagram channel, My Mother Book Studio, and I will, you can really go through these stories and the grid on my Insta handle and find out about the different things apart from maybe what we do. Now, without wasting much time, let's go ahead and see what I have for you in today's video.
All right, let's get started with our book review. Thukka for All by Prabha Ram, Sheila and Shilpa Ranade, who is the illustrator of the book. The book is published by Karadi Tales. And the story setting of this book is pretty much Indian, as I had shared. The story shares about a young blind boy whose dinner invitation brings the entire neighborhood together over a meal. One evening, while Sering was on his way back home, excited and looking forward to his abhi, grandmother's thukka, that is the noodle soup, he runs into many people from his neighborhood. And he lands up inviting them home to share the meal with him and his abhi. Once he arrives home and informs his grandmother realizes that she would need to revise the meal quantities as many guests would be there to join them for the meal. However, each guest brings along a contribution for the meal and make it pretty simple for abhi to put together thukpa with ease. Just then, the baba goes out and Abhi wonders how she will be able to cook. But Sering's skill to spot and identify things in darkness with ease works for Abhi, and she could continue preparing thukpa for everyone. Everyone sits together and enjoys this wonderful thukka meal all together. It really takes you back to the days when all of us as a community, as a neighborhood, would get together in, joy and sorrow and help each other out, with food being an integral part. I really appreciate Karadi Tales for putting this wonderful book together. It not only highlights community sharing, but also features a child with disability and, emphasizes his contribution. The rare of the book also calls attention to the traditional recipe for thukka, which I'm surely going to try, and I would want you all to do look into this recipe, which comes across really yum, and you can also try and help your children explore different cultures and cuisines. So I highly recommend this book if you're looking forward to discuss community bonding, inclusiveness and building caring and empathetic approach for humans with special needs. This book will be perfect for school and home use with children. I really feel that this book can be read to children who are 5 years old and above, and will be simply perfect, and they will enjoy this thukka for all.
Alright, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you like my recommendation, and in case you want to get a hobby for yourself, then I am leaving the link in the description down below. You can follow the link and purchase your own copy of the book. And do share your suggestions and feedback in the comment section of the video. I would love to hear from you, your suggestions, your opinions, what you think about my videos, what you would want me to create more or review more apart from books, stories, and anything else which you would like me to incorporate on my channel offering. I will be back again with another interesting video. Till then, stay tuned and thank you once again.